What's going on, guys? Zelosix here, and welcome back to another video. Alright, so this time I'll be going over the GTA cheaters in real life video and how I made it. So I'm in GTA 4 right now, and one of the things that I used to make the video is that I downloaded this gigantic green screen right behind me that's near the Statue of Liberty. And the other thing that I used for this video is the simple native trainer, whatever, kind of messed up the name. So in this trainer you can kind of just use and spawn any car you want. You can spawn any pedestrian you want, you can change the color of the cars, you can change the time, the weapons, the weather, a ton of options, guys. And trust me, if without this, the video that I made would not have been possible. So here we are inside the green screen, which you can kind of get lost with directions. It's everything is green, you can't really kind of coordinate yourself, but it's not that hard in the end. Alright, so what I do here for each shot is basically I spawn a bunch of, you know, cars or pedestrians or whatever it is that I want to be in the scene. And I play around with them, you know, I make them explode, I make them move left and right, whatever. You can see I spawned a bunch of stupid stuff right here. And the PC version of GTA 4 has a video editor in it. It's basically like theater mode from Call of Duty, where, you know, it records what you did for that specific match. But in this game, it records everything that you did the last minute or something. So you can go ahead and enter the video editor. You can bring all the scenes that you have recorded. You can change the camera angle, which is pretty interesting and really, really cool. Without that, this video would not have been possible. Now here we are inside the video editor that I was talking about, and you can kind of see I can change the camera angle. I can go wherever I like, so I can kind of place the camera right here, down, up, whenever you feel like you want to place the camera, you just place it. And after that, all you do is you hide all these elements and you record the scene just like that. You know, you can see, you can pause, you can go back, you can go fast, you can go slow, whatever that is that you want. And after that, you can bring this footage inside After Effects and you can edit it however you want. You can basically key out the green, because that's what this gigantic green screen is for. Now after I recorded the scene, I imported them inside After Effects, and as you can see right here, this is one of the scenes where the cards sort of go everywhere when they spawn. And the first thing that you do is you take out the green screen, so you can see everything that's kind of black or with kind of these blocks with white and gray blocks is transparent, and you kind of add that to the scene right here. As you can see, the shadow is still there, which is really important. And of course, we had a little bit of color corrections so these elements can fit even better with the environment. And obviously, you guys have to motion track the scene before anything. As you can see, this is all the motion tracking data. So you choose like a dot, like always, go on right click, and you click on create null and camera, and it will automatically create a null object, which to that null object you kind of connect all the elements that you want to be in the scene. And right here, as you can see, the helicopter is behind his leg because that's where he's supposed to be. You also have to do a little bit of rotoscoping sometimes. As you can see, maybe go frame by frame, and that's probably the hardest thing to do. So I mean, it's not the hardest thing, it's one of those things that takes a lot of time. So yeah, take your time and make it look as good as you can. So all in all, this video took me a lot of hours working and just compositing, editing, all that good stuff. So if you guys still haven't watched the video, go ahead and watch it, and if you want to leave a like rating, that would be always much appreciated. Other than that, see you guys next time and have a great day.